more the details between the fully technical and functional, so a bit in the middle of that, is where I have all my knowledge and just things I like to talk about. Actually, Alex already had a great session about security, so I thought I had to do something different, and let's talk about the finance and operations connector in Power Automate. And I called it Ledger Operations Flow. Today, I will first give you a brief overview of what we're going to talk about in this session. Then, finalizing the agenda, we already give those highlights. Just a brief introduction in automation introduction. What type of automations are there, and how can we leverage them? Then a bit more on the Power Automate F&O connector, some backgrounds and what actions and triggers are available. And then also I will provide some examples what you can achieve with the Power Automate flows. So let's continue to the site where we will start with explaining there are several options for doing some process automation. One of them is the business process automation, and on the other hand, there's also robotic process automation. When talking about a few years back, somewhere in 2016-2017, Microsoft came with a product, Microsoft Flow, which is now rebranded as Microsoft Power Automate. And at that time, there were also other programs like UiPath, which were more capable of doing things automatically and more act like a robot. So the real difference between just a business process automation is just where you can just streamline your business processes, pick some details from one application, probably convert a bit and move it to another process, usually work what you did do manually, like for example typing over an incoming email with an order details. It would be possible to just integrate different applications and do it automatically, and that's also all about what we today call it the digital transformation. If it is possible to do or just pick up things which is already digital, sent in a certain way, if it's structured, then you can also get it in another place, also automated. Now the difference between the business and the robotic process automation is that the robotic process automation, like also visible on the image at the right side, you can use software robots to complete certain tasks for you, and also add some artificial intelligence, like where the system can think for you and make some decisions automatically. Now, the story from Microsoft, it already began before 2019, but Microsoft started with the Microsoft Power Automate, initially called Microsoft Flow, where you could link one application, get some details, and move it to another application. There was more indeed the business process automations. And they announced somewhere in that year or around that year, we want to focus on RPA, robotic process automation. But when you look at the Gartner's Magic Quadrant, there was no Microsoft at all. And they announced we are looking for 100 plus people to help us on the RPA story. And then move 1 year further, what we see is that Microsoft was already in the quadrant as a visionary. So they had a great vision, they hired a lot of people, they were just completing things, like it was not only the cloud flows, but you could also do some more robotic actions, automate your desktops. And now just about a week ago, Gartner again published a new quadrant on the robotic process automation, And as you can see now, Microsoft is together with the common vendors like UiPath, Automation Anywhere, and Blue Prism. They're now one of the leaders in the world, acknowledged by Gartner. It's a great story. However, I will not go into the robotic process automation today. I just want to show you everything that's related to the Finance Operations Connector, because my background originally was also Finance Operations, but I'm also looking around in other products and solutions related to Dynamics 365 and the Power Platform. But with the business process automation, with help of over 500 connectors already, you can just do a lot of automation, like receiving alerts, some data exchange, you can collect data, you can use some approvals, really different things. And even just when I started to play with Power Automate, then it was possible to just click a button on an app on my phone. And at that time, it collected the location where I was, the timestamp, in an Excel sheet. So in that way, I could probably very easily in my vacation just know this was a beautiful place, just click on it, then I know for another time I want to go back there and see some more of that environment. Now, when we talk about the Finance and Operations Connector available in Power Automate, then we can do some CRUD actions, like we can create a record, we can update a record, we can delete records using the list items present in a table. You can also read data. And when you read data, you can also move it to other applications like a SharePoint list or an Excel file or whatever you want to do. You can also create an email out of it. The get a list of entities, that one, I'm not using it quite often. Actually, I looked at it once, but it's only getting the list of the available entities. And there's also an option to which is called execute action. I will tell that within a minute what you can do with that one. And also, the Finance Operations Connector has one trigger, and that's when a business event occurred. Coming back to the first ones, the create, update, and delete, it's quite easy to work with the connectors in Flow. For creating the record, it is straightforward, and regardless any setting in Finance Operations, you can just pick your data entity, check some fields what needs to be inserted, and then just click on get started. For the update and delete actions, that's a bit more cumbersome, as there are some restrictions today. Not sure if Microsoft will solve that. But if you want to update or delete a certain record, then regardless of the setting you do in the action itself for which legal entity, it's always also looking at the settings of your own user. And that means that the user executing a certain update or delete tasks should have the default company set for the legal entity you're working in. I will show you also a demo how you can bypass it later on and show you more details of how to get started with the Power Automate itself. In the past, there were some great examples where it was really easy to start with, but Microsoft did disable those examples, and they replaced it with the help of doing an approval or work with a business event, which is also a great guidance to get started with those two options. But sometimes you would like to just also get started with reading or inserting data in Finance Operations. Now, the execute action, that would enable you also to Start a certain action, like posting a journal or approving a bill of material. If that's also created as a certain action on a data entity. And I wrote all on all of these actions. I wrote several blogs. You can also find it on my blog website, dynamicspedia.com. If you search for let your operations flow or just the keyword flow, then you can find a series of about 7-8 blogs explaining in every blog one of the actions. Create, update, delete, execute action is well explained on those blogs. What you need, the finance operations connector is working with data entities which are set to be public. When you develop or look at the available data entities in finance operations, they can have a setting, is this one public, yes or no, and is it enabled for data management, yes or no, and there can be sometimes a difference in it. So if you can find a certain data entity for import-export the data, then it's not 100% guarantee that you can use the same entity also for the finance operations connector in Power Automate or any other public places. It's based on the OData protocol. And as you might have noticed, also sometimes there will be a new version of a certain data entity created by Microsoft. For example, if you look at the customers, it had a base one, but later on a version 2 and also a version 3 of the customers entity. You can just use one of them. However, Microsoft also is marking them sometimes as obsolete, meaning that they can be really removed from the system within a certain period of time. So that means that you sometimes have to check if there will be a new version available. If there's a new one, also check if you can update all your flows or other OData actions using the older data entity. Now there are also some caveats. Using data entities or using the Power Automate, you have to consider the performance. If you are working with the Power Automate using the OData, the performance is not designed to do a high load of records. So that means that just a few records would be great, but doing 10,000 of records inserting or updating, it would be really slow in performance compared to just doing the same task with the data import-export framework by importing a file in finance operations. Also, sometimes you have to do some development effort and you really have to take care of things that should work correctly. When you add new fields, or probably if you want to add some virtual columns, then you really have to test if it will be working correctly. Sometimes the reading part is okay, but updating might take some additional efforts to get it really correctly working. That's about the demo time. And I'll show you some examples. And the first one is how to get started with a first Power Automate flow. Then I will create one example where we will insert some customer groups from an Excel file. And this one is just having some standard customer groups 10, 20, 30 until 90. And if you go to flow, if you want to start flow, you can go to flow.microsoft.com. If you are already a user, you will be logged in and you can continue to work. If not, you can just start for free the first 30 days. And depending on certain licenses in finance operations, you also have some rights to use Power Automate or Power Apps. That means if you're a finance user or a supply chain user, at least on operational level, you are able to work with flows using the finance and operations connector. The team members and activity users are excluded from the rights, so then you need to purchase additional licenses to also have them working with the finance and operations. I will start by creating a new flow now. It will just an instant cloud flow. I want to manually trigger this flow. I didn't provide a name yet. And for the flow, as first of all, I want to insert an input, and the input would be I need a company where the data needs to be inserted. Copy to insert the data. Then as a second step, I have a list with a file already in Excel available. So I want to use an Excel online connector, and I want to list all the rows present in a table. To be able to work with Excel data, all the data needs to be present in a table. It's not possible to just read an additional or just an individual cell. It all needs to be in a certain table. Now I have to find where is my file. And I have it on my OneDrive. Power Automate, next one. The demos, and I created one file with some customer groups with three records in it. And when we open the file, there's one table available, customer groups table, which is having now four columns, just the group name, description, the text group, and also the terms of payment. This will just read the table. Officially, I have to create a loop first before I can work with the individual rows, but I will directly just start with the finance and operations connector now, because when I click a certain action, at a certain point of time, when I will use some data of the Excel sheet, it will just add automatically the loop, which I will show you within a minute. I want to create a new record now. So you have to select your finance and operations instance. I'll take this one. And as the entity name, should start with the customer. Oops. And this error may occur when there's a bit of timeout before you really select the entity name. So it's a bit of impatience. It's not a serious one. Just ensure you have the correct entity name, and then the error will be gone as soon as possible. Now we have the entity name provided as the customer groups. It will now show you all available fields, initially just the key fields like the customer group and for what company. And with the advanced options, you will get all other fields as well. So the customer group is in my Excel sheet. And when I click the group, it will just link the group, but also now apply to each to loop the whole table present in Excel. When I open it again, I also have to provide the company, but that was inserted as a parameter. I'm not able to see it now as an automatic content. There it is. For the company, for the description, I can link the name field. Then we have the terms of payment. And it's just clicking and the fields will be linked. And it's not possible to do it on all fields. If you have a date field or a quantity or integer field, you have to use an expression to convert the text to the data format for finance and operations. And I have another example, also by creating purchase orders from a file. It's using quite a lot of quantities and date fields. That one is also available on my website as a blog, but you can also download the example and then learn from it in your own environment. Now, what we have now is just when we start the flow manually, we have to provide an input parameter. It will pick up the list with records, and for each record, it will create a record in finance and operations. It would be best practice to also just rename all the actions with just meaningful names, so you can, not only you, but also other persons, probably in the future, need to review or enhance the flow, will be able to understand what's going on. I'll save it now. And once it's saved, I can test it or run it. And testing is in fact also running. It will ask you, do you want to use the Excel Online and the Finance Operations connectors? This is what I already provided before. The first time you will link an Excel or what type of connector, you have to provide some credentials which will be linked in your flow. Now, when I start the flow, I have to provide a company. So I will provide now USMF. I will run the flow. It is running. When I click done, you will also get an overview of what is going on. It will now list the rows present in a certain table and apply to each. You can see there were three records. And when looping all of them, they did not have any issue at all. When you open the details, you can also find details of what was read or what actions were done by the system. And also, in case if there are certain errors, you can do some troubleshooting by looking in the details or the steps which did fail. Now, going back to the customer groups form, when I refresh this one and read the data again, let me check. I'm in the wrong company. So that's. Go to the USMF company, open the customer groups. You now see that there are three records inserted for the Urdu, Hindi, group 10, 20, and 30. Also, I mentioned when you want to update records or delete records from another company compared to your base company, then you can expect an error. But there's a way to get around it. First of all, when you look at my user options in this environment, as preferences, my default company is now USMF. So when I go to my flows, I already created one. That's a demo how to temporarily change the user default company and then add a certain action. I will open this one and first show you in detail what I did. It will be just for this demo now and manual as well. And it will use a variable where the current default company of the user will be stored. That variable will be filled in this group. Then I will change the default company to DEMF. Then I can create a record and also update that same record. And at the end of the script, you can reset the default company of the user. This is working if you know if there will be nothing impacted in between. If you intend to run 10 different flows at the same time, all for different companies, then it might just not work at all. then you probably need to have certain users in your finance operations environment using different legal entities as a base legal entity. But the initial one is just get the system user records. It's just using the list items in an entity. And this one is just looking at the system user's entity, where it will filter the alias field with the user email, and that's the current user starting this flow. When we have that user, it will use to apply to each, but it will only return one record because I said I need only one record. Then it can just fill the default company with the company value of the record found. Then we go for updating the records. Then we have to provide certain fields mandatory, but we can copy that one from the record already read above, and we can change the company to DEMF. Then we can create a record and update a certain record. And for updating a record, you can define also the finance operations environment, the customers groups entity, and the object ID. The object ID is the primary key of the table. Could be one field or multiple fields. And in case of multiple fields, you have to separate all field values with a comma. And in this case, it's just an entity which is where the data is separated per legal entity. Then you have to start with the company ID, then the comma, and then every field part of the primary key of the table. So in this case, DEMF and Urdu Hindi is the customer group I created just the step before. And this one will be changed, like there will also be a description provided in addition. And at the end, it will reset in the system users the company which was stored in the variable default company. Now click on test, then we can run this one. And as you can see, for certain actions, you can look at the number of seconds, then you know the time used for processing. It can vary a bit of depending on latencies or just responsiveness of the application. But it's correctly set already. And now when I go to the DEMF company, and the customer groups, you'll see that without any error, a record was not only inserted but also updated in another legal entity compared to my base legal entity. And when you look at the user options, the company is set back to USMF like nothing happened before. When look at the time, the time flies. I also wanted to show you something about importing the purchase orders, but actually I did create a blog, but also a video, how that's all working. So on my website, you can find that demo and also download it and how it's working together. Sometimes, just another topic. In the past, I got sometimes questions. I want to have just an email once in a week about certain alerts of things that happened before it in the environment, like which positions were created last or were linked to workers or just position changes of last week or other things. When you look at the alert functionality in finance operations, it will just alert directly for every change in the system. Then I thought, well, I could try to use it using Power Automate and read all records created or changed after a certain timestamp. When you look in finance operations, you might know that there will be if enabled on a table and created daytime or a modified daytime. However, those fields are in most cases not enabled on data entities. And if you want to enable it on tables and the data entities, there will be quite some additional development effort, which can be bypassed in a completely different way. And what I did do is use an bring your own database, a new database on Azure. When you do certain settings, you can export data initially, but also then incremental. So in the system administration data management, you can configure entity export to a database, which what I did now. And for these settings, I published certain entities and in an alert email, I'm combining now the vendor information and the bank account information to be displayed and only the changes of last week. Apart from this, you have to just, when you enable the change tracking, you have to create an data job which will export the data regularly. You can set it to return every hour or every day, and in this case I did it every day. It will have a result in the database, and now with Management Studio I'm able to look at the details. So we have the vendor staging, the vendor bank account, and the dear party. And every time when you change something, the change tracking will tell the data job to export only the new created records or the change records. And what happens with the export of the entity, it will also include another additional column, which is the sync start date time. And using this timestamp, we can loop all records and filter out which ones we don't need. So for example, all records created on 27 of July are not interesting and of interest anymore. I only would like to see data of the most recent changes in an email. What we can do is just loop or take the base table and then have another action to also collect the vendor bank account details or from the SQL or from a data entity in finance operations using the finance operations connector. But actually you can also create a view already in the bring your own database, which will then combine the data required for your flow. But it's just having a minimum of information, the vendor account number, the bank account, and organization name, and some of the details, but also the synchronization start date time of the vendor again. Now I created one simple flow. Go back to my flows. The vendor change tracking and edit. I'm using some variables. It will run daily at 7, but you can also set it for weekly. The days of history, it will look at the last 4 days, but you can also say I want to have it for 7 days. And one example of, or just one variable to check if any record was found in the log or not. If there's nothing. Then we don't have to send an email. There will be a log text. That one is used to collect data in a certain table, which will be included in the email. And we need to split the dates into a day, month, and year to be able to get the data as of a certain date. And actually, it's looking at multiple different settings to check for a certain date. It's not just greater than a date of 4 days ago. It's just looking at or the day is greater or equal, or the month is greater or equal, or the year is greater than something. And that's just something related to the way of getting the data out of the SQL database. So it will look at USMF data only, sorted by vendor organization name. And for each change found, it will first of all say, I found one or more records, otherwise it remains false. And it will just include a certain text for each row, a table row, if which is HTML format, with the table data, all different columns with values out of the SQL connector. And the full details will be sent by an email in a certain HTML format, showing some data, having some table headers, and then the full text, which is linked here, just as part of the loop, it will be appended, and that will ensure an email will be sent, including all the details. Now I'll run this one, and then in between go to the emails. When I go to Outlook, I will show you one demo, which is already sent earlier today. What you can see is this is a demo email. You can create a certain HTML format with just any logo or text, demo email, and you will find the details sent, just collected over a period of time instead of just getting alert per individual change. So we're almost at the end of the time for my presentations. I would like to thank you for attending. I would like to tell more and more about all kind of changes, difference, and tips and hints, but unfortunately there's no time for it. If there are any questions, I would like to hear them. And if there's no time left for questions, then just also please reach out to me or on the Dynamics community and ask your questions, and I would be happy to assist you.
Hi, Henry. Thank you for the great session. It was quite intense and a lot of information was there. So I can see there are a couple of questions. If we can spare one more minute just to quickly ask. So the question is coming from Rachid, and that is, I think, about some rumor on the FinOps connector. They are going to be depreciated. So do you know anything more around it, and what's your thoughts on it at all?
I don't think the finance operations connector will go anywhere. I think it will stay as is. However, Microsoft is investing in getting data in or just connected with Dataverse as being it looks like it is one, as you can already work with virtual entities. So I think there will be probably more ways to interact with the data in the future, but the finance operations connector will stay as is, as part of my information.
Excellent. All right. Okay. I got another question. I think that's coming from the community again. Where we can find the list of all available Power Automate connector?
The list of all available connectors is available also on Flow, or this on the Microsoft Power Automate website. If you go to the initial web page, there's an option to look at all the connectors. Quickly, where is it? There are popular services, but you can also look at see all 507 services. And then you get a list of everything that is available to connect with.